Shepherd of our souls, Shepherd of our souls,
Savior of our souls, Lover of our souls.
We are on the Lord's side. We will never give up. We are overcomers, for the Lord God is on our side. We are on the Lord's side. We will never give up. We
our most holy Father, we thank you, we bless you, we worship you, we magnify you because you are a good God. Father, I thank you because you brought people who are on the same mind, people who are not ready to preach it the way people want to hear it. Father, here we are again. You are a God that have no respect of persons. Lord Jesus, we love you for that. I and everyone on this mountain, we say, we prefer to be flung into your kingdom than to be pressed into hell. So therefore, speak to us in the language we will understand. No matter how hard it is, Father, no matter how difficult, say it to us. And we know you will give us the grace to bear it in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Father, the Bible says your word is like a hammer. Father, hammer our heart again and dissolve that block. Dissolve whatever goes in our hearts away in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I surrender my mouth to you. My tongue is yours. And speak my ear. In Jesus Christ's mighty name, we pray.
Amen.
Message we have this morning is titled The Ark of Greediness and Confusion. The Ark of Greediness and Confusion. Or you can subtitle it this way: Greedy Leaders and Confused Followers. Greedy leaders and confused followers. While the minister was preaching yesterday, the Spirit of God began to minister to me. If you look me very well today, as a minister, I was writing things. I was writing what the Spirit of God was telling me. Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
2 Corinthians chapter 5, 18 to 21. 2 Corinthians 5, 18 to 21. And all things are of God, who has reconciled us to himself by Jesus Christ, and has given to us the ministry of what? Reconciliation. Man, he has given to us, plural, the ministry of reconciliation and brings away. 9. To wit, that God was in Christ reconciling the world unto himself, not imputing their transgression unto them, and have committed unto us, plural again, the word of reconciliation. 20. Now then, we are ambassadors, we, plural again, are ambassadors for Christ, as though God did beseech you beset you, that with us, we pray you in Christ, said, be ye reconciled to God. 21. For he hath made him to be sin for us, who knew no sin, that we might be made the righteousness of God in him. Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Now, it is surprising when the Lord Jesus Christ has said by himself that he has given me, given this woman, given his child, giving all every one of us the ministry of reconciling people to himself, the ministry of bringing people to him. The other time, a sister told me, the sister was in our midst then, he said, man of God, I am afraid. I said, why? He said, because there is a ministry that came in Nigeria, in Eastern region. He said, the man of God said that he is the only one that Jesus Christ said must bring people to him. And anyone that does not join them will die. Say, hey. And the man of God said that everyone in that ministry, God told him they must not own their land. They must not build their house. That God said everything is for him. So if you are there, you connect everything you have to them, because they are the one leading you to heaven. And the sister was shaking. I said, what are you saying? He said, yeah, he said, man of God, I believe them. I said, eh? You believe them? I said, okay, I have nothing to say again. And the daughter of God left this ministry and went back and joined them. And as the man of God preached yesterday, the Lord said to me, in my spirit, that most of these people, they are not working for him. The act they said they are building is the act of greediness. This one will say, the Lord said to me that we are the only people that will lead people to heaven. The Lord said to me, he said to this one, that you are the only people. He said to this one, that you are the only people. Who is that God that will tell this one, you are the only person? Will come and meet this one, you are the only person. Who is that God? But I've come to introduce the true God to you today. Who is saying here, he has given me, given you the ministry of reconciliation. To reconcile people to him. And the Spirit of God said to me yesterday, they have succeeded in confusing his children. And in the act they say they have built for themselves is the act of greediness and confusion. They are everywhere. All they want to do is to siphon money. Their message is to put fear in the heart of people and subject them. Not the fear of God. If we're preaching about the fear of God, they are preaching about the fear of the ministry. Succeeded in putting the fear of God away from the heart of men and put the fear of their ministry in the heart of people. And God said, he will pay for the greediness of the last day. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Many leaders have succeeded in removing Jesus Christ from the heart of their members and putting themselves and their commission into their heart. The Bible told us in the book of John, chapter 14, verse 6, Jesus said unto him, I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. No man cometh to me of coming unto the Father, but by me. But by him. The Lord Jesus Christ never said, it was thee to one person, but by him. Not to only judge this ministry. The reason why this ministry is here is for all church to gather to hear the truth. If I come and tell you, the Lord said to me that only mountain of solution and redemption people can make heaven run away. It means it's not the heaven of God I'm taking you to. Because the Lord has a lot of people out there bringing people to him. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
The Bible tells us a woman in the Bible asked the Lord to write something. When he met the woman by the well of Jacob, in John chapter 8, praise the Lord. Sorry. It was asked to Jesus Christ, I know, in John chapter 8, verse 31 to 32, the Jews asked him, Jesus, what shall we do? How do we know the way? And he told them here, in John 8, 31 to 32, then said Jesus to the Jews, which believe on him, if you continue in my word, then are ye my disciples indeed. 32, and you shall know the truth, and the truth shall do what? Shall make you free. The ark that will take to heaven is truth. Hallelujah. The only ark that can take a man to heaven is the ark of truth. Anyone that is in that ark of truth, heaven is sure for you. If you are in a congregation, no matter how it's well painted, no matter it's well garnished, as far as the truth there is no complete, or there's no truth there, you are in the ark of confusion, the ark of doom. And there are so many acts today built by greedy men, nurturing confused people into their damnation. I've come to announce to you the only act that can take you to heaven if the act of truth is written here. You and I shall know the truth, and the truth shall make us free. There is no other freedom anywhere. Apostle Manley cannot make you free. Only the word of God can make you free. Mountain of solution and redemption on its own, the name cannot make you free. Only the truth in the ministry can set them free. Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
The Bible tells us in Romans chapter 5, 8 to 11. But God commanded his love towards us, in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Christ died for us. 9. Much more then, being now justified by his blood, we shall be saved from the wrath to him. 10. For if, when we were enemy, we were reconciled to God by the death of his son, much more being reconciled, we shall be saved by his life. Level. And not only so, but we also joy in God through our Lord Jesus Christ, by whom we have now received the atonement. There have never been any other way. There have never been any other way but the way of truth through Jesus Christ. The only one that has the power to take you and I to the Father is Christ. Regardless who you go through, as far as through Christ, in truth, in spirit and in truth, I tell you, heaven is guaranteed for you. As far the way is the way that passed through Jesus, must come to the gate of Christ, and he will not direct you. Jesus knows the way to that promised land. All we have to do is to follow. Only Jesus knows the way to that promised land. All we have to do is to follow. The Bible told us in Colossians chapter 1 verse 19, for it pleases the Father that him shall all fully dwell. Him shall all fully dwell. If you go to heaven tomorrow, nobody will be asking you, come and see Mark of Solution here. What we have in heaven is saints, the angels of God, the saints of God, regardless of how you come there, as far as through Jesus. The Lord will not send you away because you've not passed through Mount of Solution and redemption. If you are here, you are not in holiness and righteousness. I tell you, Mount of Solution cannot save you. No church, no ministry can save anybody. What saved man is the word of God in truth. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Verse 20 of Colossians 1. And having made peace through the blood of his cross, that he to reconcile all things unto himself, that he, I say, whether the things in earth are things in heaven. 21. And you that were something alienated and enemy in your mind by wicked words, yet now has he reconciled. Who is doing it? Jesus Christ. No other man, no other mercy but Christ. And they have given every one of us the day that born again. He gave you the ministry of reconciliation. The ministry of reconciliation is a general ministry to everyone that I Christ Jesus. Are you in America? Draw men to him. If I be lifted up, I will draw men to myself. He draw you. Draw somebody else. Draw somebody else. We all are given the ministry of reconciliation to bring people to God. And the Holy Spirit is the captain of that boat. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. So we say, I am the prophet, the Elijah of this time. Somebody called me one time in America. He said, man of God. I said, yes. He said, I want to let you know that the prophet, the Elijah that the Lord said talk about is so basic. That we all must follow that man. That the Elijah has come. I said, Elijah has come. He said, my sister, you are a rebel. Okay? I said, you are a rebel. What do you mean? Say, anyone that's rebelling against the word of God is a rebel. What did the word say? What did Christ say? Are you telling me what the Lord said or what I told you? He said, sir, my eyes can see it. So some people, the Elijah is in Kenya. To some people, the Elijah is in Nigeria. Maybe to some people, the Elijah is what? Is in Cameroon. But what did Jesus Christ say is, people have decided to be living a confused life. Why? Because greedy men has engulfed them. Why people are looking at men this day as the Elijah that the Bible talk about? The Bible told us in the book of Matthew, chapter 17. Matthew 17, verse 9. And as they came down from the Mount of Transfiguration, as they came down from the mountain, Jesus charged them, saying, tell the vision to no man. Until the Son of Man be risen again from the dead. Let's see what the disciples ask him. The apostles rather. Hey. And the disciples ask him, say, why then say this cry that Elias, which is Elijah, must first come? He said confusion, that people were confused that the Antichrist answered it. Even after Christ has answered the question, some people have still decided to be confused to their own doom today. Verse 11. And the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ answered and said unto them, Elias truly shall first come and restore all things. Verse 12. But I say unto you, that Elias is come already. Well, some people are saying now, greatest of the mighty, mighty prophets, so in their Elijah, now prepare a place for God. Elijah has come to prepare a place for Christ. That means the apostles were wasting time then. Everything they are doing then is still wasted. If another Elijah was come to go and prepare a place, to go and maintain the airport that he will land. Hallelujah. 12. But I say unto you that Elias is come already, and they knew he not, but have done unto him whatsoever they listed. Likewise shall also the Son of Man suffer of them. Verse 13. Then the disciples, who has wisdom, understood that he spoke unto them of John the Baptist. This one is really clear. Some people are saying this is the ark. Elijah's ark has come to prepare a place for their Jesus. Not by all. The ark of greediness and confusion. Mark 19:11-23. And they asked him, saying, why say this cry that Elijah must first come? Matthew said it. And he answered and told them, Elijah will come first and restore all things, and how it is written of the Son of Man, that he must suffer many things and be set at naught. 13. For I say unto you that Elijah is indeed come, and they have done unto him whatsoever they listed, as it is written of him. Now I ask this question. Will Jesus Christ now told them that this one is Elijah? Now, most of these people, they pretend as the same vision. Don't wonder people will not enter heaven under the true vision. What we stand that day is the word of God. And people are following it. They are drawing crowd everywhere in their acts of confusion. And you also, who the Lord is teaching morning and night about the word of God, you will disconnect now and connect yourself to the ark of confusion. Many people are working now. They are afraid to spend their money because the man said nobody has the right over his money. So many people now have the money to buy and to build up. But the man said nobody has the right to build up. If you build it, you must name it up to the Lord. Who is the Lord? Him. Through him. And people are there. Act of greediness. And confused men and women are there. I will know the heaven they are going to. Praise Master Jesus.
Mark 9.
Praise the Lord. The Bible told us in Malachi 4, verse 5. Behold, I will send you. This is where they are confused. Even when Christ has explained the riddle to them. I will send you Elijah, the prophet, before the coming of the great and dreadful day of the Lord. Verse 6. And he shall turn the heart of the father So the children, just as Christ told them, he has actually John the Baptist have actually reconciled all things before I come. And the heart of the children to their father, lest I come and split the earth with a cross. And that is why Christ died, so that God will not destroy us, just as he destroyed Sodom and Gomorrah. And that is the grace we are enjoying today. Until that day, when he will come and take his elect away. But today, people are foolishly following men that call themselves prophets, that they are the Elijah. People are foolishly running into places. Some call themselves they are the ark. Some say they are the plane. Some say they are the only this. Only this. That is, you are limited God. You are limited Jesus Christ. And I refuse to limit him in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The Bible told us in Acts chapter 1 verse 8, but ye shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost is come upon you. And you and I and we, I paraphrase, shall be witness unto him. This is Christ speaking here. Shall be witness unto him, both in Jerusalem and in Judea and in Samaria and unto the uttermost parts of the earth. These people who are doing all this, what are they doing? Are they not leading people to heaven? Is it to reconcile people back to God and bring them to heaven? But now, some people are saying they met Jesus Christ face to face on his throne. And he told them, anyone that is not in the one, somewhere in Anambra or so, Nigeria, there are even many in Nigeria. There are even many there in Africa. No, it is surprising. Most of them only in Africa you hear all those nonsense things. Yes. Africa, you hear of things unspeakable. Things that you will not be bold to say in your mouth. They will say it and they will go away with it and people follow them. When Jesus Christ is spreading his power everywhere, the Bible says on the last day, the Lord shall unleash his anointing upon all men. But today, one man is saying, I am the one. If you don't follow Apostle Emmanuel, you are on your way to hell. God forbid. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
A woman asked the Lord Jesus Christ in John 4, verse 20 to 24. Let's see how Christ answered him. John 4:20. Our Father worship in this mountain. And you say that in Jerusalem is a place where men ought to worship. You say that it's only on the mountain of solution and redemption. Only this mountain men ought to worship. Minister Fenda say, God forbid, that only those that come to Mount of Solution Island branch will make heaven in Ireland. God forbid. Even though the rest are not preaching holiness, doing the right thing, as far as they are not come to the new rented apartment of Mount of Solution, nobody will enter heaven. It means anyone that was here before, now disconnected from us, and still keep on with holiness and righteousness, will not make heaven. God forbid. What takes to heaven is your connection to God, the fear of God in your life, the truth of Christ, you know, the deeper you go with him in holiness and righteousness is what takes to heaven. not the confinement of the place you are. Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Let's see what Christ told the woman, who was also confused the way many people are confused today. Even when Christ has explained to us that many people have decided to be confused, that greedy masters have taken over their hearts. Verse 21. Jesus said unto her, just as he explained to the disciples just now, woman, believe me, the hour cometh when you shall neither in this mountain nor yet in Jerusalem worship the Father. Then ask this question, where are we worshiping the Father now? If it's not in Jerusalem or in just in this mountain, where? Hallelujah. From your heart. The beauty does not matter. The reason why we are gathered together is for us to dig deep. It's for us to share it. It's for us to enlighten each other. Neither on this mountain or in Jerusalem. Christ speaking. 22. Ye worship what ye know not. We know what we worship, for salvation is of the Jews. Verse 23. But the hour cometh, and now is when the true worshippers, these are the people God is looking for. The true worshippers shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth. If you enter that ark in carnality, you will go to hell. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
No matter how they paint it, no matter how what they say about it, no matter how I and Mr. Peace paint the mountain solution, if you are here in carnal mindedness, you go to hell. If you are here, the truth enters from here and it goes out from here, you go to hell. So many people have seen about two or three people who said God, they were in the dream, they saw revelation, rapture. We are all gathered on the mountain. Just 2 days ago now, a sister from UK, that she's not regular here, wrote me, I said, man of God, this is what I saw tonight. The rapture took place while we are gathered on the mountain. Man, I read it to you. I mean, the rapture took place on the mountain. Some people left and some did not go. Said those that left were having candle at the front of their Bible. Don't let the light of truth quench. Just as the 7 virgins, 5 were foolish, 5 were wise. Those who have the word of God in them, the light of God, as my God said this morning, they are the only people that will see on that day. Those that have the light shining around them, those are the only that God will see on that day to pick away. She said they were having candle at their front to the body. No wonder the Bible says the fire was not quenched. On the mountain, some left, some were there. Why? It is not the same mountain? Are we not on the same mountain? But carnality will make some people to let that day. The name Mountain of Solution will not save you on that day. What will save you is the truth on the mountain. Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Verse 24. God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. And today, so many pastors have succeeded in taking the spirit of their neighbor from them and they have given them carnal mind. Worshiping God carnally, worshiping the the Spirit of God with carnality. And I say, as long as we act, as long as we are in Shemesh, as long as we are Catholic, as long as we are in Mountain, as long as we will make it with Israelite. That's why when people leave this mountain, the only thing I'm praying in my heart, Father, please don't let them go to a place where the truth is lower than this place. I'm telling you my heart. Hey, that brother that left, I pray where he or she is going to. It's a place where they will take him or her deeper in truth more than they know yet. Because I know if they go a little lower of the truth you know yet, hell is guaranteed. If you go to a place and the truth they tell there, they say there, is 1% lower than the truth on this mountain, you can't make to heaven. It's either it's equal to or it's far, far higher. If you go below down this mountain, hell is guaranteed for him. Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
I ask this question. What ark are you? Are you in the ark of confusion? Be paddled by greedy people. All they do is to give revelation that will make you fear. Fearful revelation, not to fear God, but to make you fear them. They will not last long. Those acts that are pushing people to hell, pretending they are taking people to heaven, and all they do is to scaffold them, looking for people everywhere. No wonder this guy said to the Pharisees, he said, you people, you will go everywhere to draw men to yourself, and when the man comes, you make them more hardened than you. That is what they are doing today. And I pray, God in his mercy, who gave me this message yesterday when his blood was about to be sent, when his little boy was preaching, we go into this act of greediness and deliver those confused children of his out of that place. And himself, we paddle them. His kingdom in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
A word is enough for the wise. I want to stand up and say, Father, look at the ark I am. Am I in the ark of confusion? Be paddled by greediness? Or am I my own self greedy person? My own self confused person? Father, deliver me today. And as many are there who believe they must make heaven because they are in one act. And meanwhile, they are saying that to hell. They are teaching them nonsense. Teaching them what Christ cannot even listen to. Say, Father, have mercy and deliver them. Even the greedy dogs who are leading them, deliver them too. Because only devil knows what he's doing. Both the greedy leaders and the confused people, both of them don't know what they're doing. Father, deliver your children this day. In Jesus Christ's mighty name, open your mouth and pray.
Father, in the name of Jesus, Father, in the name of Jesus, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, my Father and my God, Father, please send to act in me right now. Father and my God, don't send me myself, Baba, whatsoever that is in me, Baba, that darkness, whatsoever, that will not allow me to be Baba. Father, please, I am begging you to take it away from my life, Baba. Father, please, I don't want to be there, Baba. I don't want to be there, Baba. I am begging you, Baba, mercy upon my soul. Have mercy upon my children, Baba, that I reveal myself to you, Baba. Whatever that I'm doing, Baba, whatever that is not of my soul, Baba.
Don't worry, it's network. Let me repeat one more time. Anyone that come at them, no one that they just say to us, if they tell you that it's on the mountain, don't go. If in the valley, don't go. Anyone that come out and say he is the Elijah, that person is fighting God. He's fighting the word of God. They are waiting for their Antichrist. They look anti and put Christ there. But they know that what they are saying is Antichrist. No, another Elijah that is coming. No single act that will lead people to heaven. What will lead people to heaven is the name of Christ in holiness. I want to pray all those Antichrist people that call themselves Elijah, call themselves whatever they are, Father, please begin to disgrace them. Open the eyes of your children before your children are totally doomed. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, open up the prayer.
Amen. Father, in the name of Jesus,
are you here? You are not born again. You are your own self, really doomed and capsizing boat. You are your own self confused person. Except you come to Christ Jesus, you are doomed already. Are you out there? You want to come to Christ? I'm not saying come to me. No. I'm not saying you must come to this mountain. No. All I'm saying, be born again. It's not left for you to say, okay, there's truth here. Let me say here and keep on hearing the truth. Or there's a place that a harder truth. Not a pet one, they bet you and miss all your and water together. This clay and iron together. No. It is clay. And it's clay. Yay! Yay! Nay! Nay! That is the word of God. Not yay, nay. Yay, nay. It's either it is yes or no. Say after me. If you have to give your life to that Christ who was ye, amen. Say, Father, I've come to you. I realized that I was on my way to everlasting damnation. My heart deceived me, but your light has shone on me now. Forgive me for my sin. Forgive me for ever believing in lies. I repent of my sin today. My door is open for you. Come into my heart. Come and dwell in me. Take my name away from the book of death and write it in the book of life. I accept you, Lord Jesus Christ, as my only Lord and personal Savior. I am born again today. All things have passed away. All things have become new. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for delivering my soul. I go down to follow you alone through your word and by the help of the Holy Spirit. So help me, God, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. With you, you can confess this confession. My Father, my God, I thank you. I bless you and worship you because you're a good God. Father, you have spoken to those who have ears to hear. Because I know not everybody that have ears that hears. Father, those who have ears that heard, the grace to understand and do according to as you desire, so that on the last day we'll not be found naked, thinking we are well dressed. Help your children. Help me to know more of you. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Are there that be deceived, confined in a place, suffering and smiling? No matter how you tell them, they know this is a lie, but because of the fear they have put in them, if you go away, we might go and die, and you'll see us in hell. Father, please, in your mercy, reveal yourself to them and put them away from those acts of greediness and confusion in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
Because I know you will always tell the truth.
Amen.
In Jesus Christ, mighty name, we are praying.
Amen.
Amen.
Over to you, Mama God.
Praise Master Jesus Christ.